Let's come into a staff pose, straightening our legs. Our legs are parallel, side by side. Tummies are tucked in at our navel. Our backs are nice and elongated. Toes are pointing up towards the heavens. That heart chakra is lifted, that chin is up. Taking a nice deep breath. Exhale through the mouth. Breathe in deeply. Exhale. Taking a moment to notice how we feel in our bodies. Placing our palms on our laps. Two breaths. As we come into a half forward fold, just noticing how that seated forward fold feels in the body. You may feel this behind your legs and your hamstrings. So we are stretching and lengthening here. And if we choose, we can go all the way down to a seated forward fold, connecting our hands to our ankles or the bottoms of our feet. Allowing that head to melt downward, shoulders flows forward. Four breaths. Two more breaths. Exhaling back up to half. Coming back to our staff pose. We're gonna cross our feet at our ankles, coming onto our hands and our knees, tabletop pose. Palms are flat on the earth, knees are hip distance apart. We're gonna drop that tummy down, coming into our cow. Chin is slightly up. Noticing how this cow pose relaxes and soothes that lumbar spine, your lumbar back. Flow into our cat. Chin comes to clavicle, spinal cord flows up towards the heavens. Exhale into cow. As we do a couple of cat cows to our natural breath. Two more breaths. Finding our paws at table. As we extend our right leg towards the back, feeling that stretch. As we extend our left arm forward, we are in that sunbird pose. This here is a balancing act. Is a balancing pose. Right legs to the back, left arms forward as we are gaze forward. Optioning to lower our right toes downward towards the earth to build balance. Four breaths. Two breaths. Exhaling back to table. Dropping down to cow. Exhale, cat. Come into our table as we extend that left leg towards the back. Right arm flows forward, sunbird, opposite side. Optioning to lower those right toes or left toes, down to the earth for balance if you choose, or keep that leg straight to the back. Tummies are tucked in at our navel. Four breaths. Two more breaths. Coming back to our table. As we flow into a down dog, gazing at our feet. Walking our dog by pedaling our legs left and right. As we find that pause, we're gonna breathe our right leg to our right hand, flowing into that runner's lunge. Now we're gonna exhale to that pyramid, straightening that front leg. Feeling that stretch, allowing that torso to relax over that thigh. Head melts downward towards the knee. Three breaths. Two breaths. Feeling that stretch here behind the leg and the hamstring. We're gonna hold this pose and we're gonna bend that right leg forward.
Flowing into a low lunge, palms touching the earth. Dropping that knee, coming into a runner's lunge. Runner's lunge. Knee off the earth, low lunge. Knee on the earth, runner's lunge.
Holding this runner's lunge for two more breaths. Then we're gonna hold this pose and we're gonna allow our buttocks to come back to our heel. We're gonna come into that half split. Maybe yogi walking that right foot slightly forward, and just, you may be on the back of your heel here, and allow that torso to come downward towards that thigh. And you'll feel this stretch behind your legs and your hamstrings. So yes, we are working our hamstrings here today. This half split prepares the body and the mind for split. It is a soothing, lengthening, and stretching pose. Three breaths. Two more breaths. Slowly exhaling out, putting that right foot flat on the earth, coming back into that runner's lunge. Our left knee is still on the earth. Our right foot is flat on the earth. We are in that runner's lunge. We're gonna breathe this right hand inside of our foot. Both of our hands are flat on the earth. And now we're gonna try to go into a lizard, coming down on our forearms, just allowing the torso, the body to come in even more. We can option to use that yoga block. Put that yoga block in front of us, that way we're not so close to the earth. Or we can come all the way down to that earth. This here is a hip opener, is further preparing our body for split. So now we're in this lizard pose. And if this is too deep, we can just lift our torso up, coming on our hands as opposed to our forearms. Two more breaths. Slowly exhaling up, coming onto our hands. Palms are flat on the earth. Breathing this right hand outside of our leg. Coming off that knee, low lunge. We're in a low lunge, not a runner's lunge, yes. Just for a second, we're going to extend this right arm up in the air, feeling that extended twist. This is our revolved twist because our body is twisting towards that thigh. We can gaze up at our right fingertips, feeling that heart chakra open. Chin is slightly up. And this is the pose Cynthia was talking about. We can option to wrap this right arm around our backs and gaze over that right shoulder. Coming a little deeper in that twist. Whatever feels good for you. Two more breaths. Exhaling back down. Coming into that pyramid, straightening that front leg. This here is a counter stretch to the poses we just did, noticing how this pyramid relaxes and soothes, allowing that torso to relax over that thigh, head melts downward. Four breaths. Two more breaths.
Low lunge, bending that knee.
Exhale, down dog, gazing at the feet. Walking our dog by pedaling our feet left and right. As we find our pause, we're gonna breathe our left hand to our left foot. Holding this pose just for a second. As we come into a pyramid pose, straightening that left leg, torso relaxes over that thigh, head melts down. Three more breaths. Exhale, bending that knee, coming back to that runner's lunge. As we lower that right knee down to the earth, now we're in that low lunge. Holding this pose for two breaths. And we're gonna straighten that front leg, coming into a half split. Noticing how this feels. Working the opposite side, working that opposite hamstring. Forehead relaxes downward towards that thigh. Shoulders melt forward. Two more breaths. Slowly lifting the body, coming back into that low lunge or runner's lunge. Let's stay in our runner's lunge. Right knee is still on the earth. We're gonna take this left hand and bring it inside of that left leg. Both palms are flat on the earth. We're gonna flow down to our lizard, if that feels good. Optioning to use that block to relax your forearms on, or you can bring your forearms all the way down to the earth. This lizard pose here preps and prepares the body for split. We are opening up those thighs. Noticing how it feels in the body, optioning to come out at any time. Four more breaths. Two breaths. Slowly exhaling out, using our hands to push our bodies up. We're gonna keep our palms flat on the earth just for a second. Catching our breath, noticing how we feel in the body. And if all feels well, we're gonna take, let's breathe this left hand outside of that left leg. As we twist our bodies towards the left, extending that left arm up in the air, gazing at the fingertips, optioning to take that right knee off the earth. So we can be in a low lunge twist or a runner's lunge twist, whatever feels best for you. Feeling that heart chakra open as we lift that left arm up. And we can option to wrap this left arm around our backs and gaze over that left shoulder. Going a little deeper into the pose, whatever feels good. Three breaths. Two more breaths. Slowly exhaling forward, placing both palms flat on the earth. Breathing this left hand outside of that knee. Flowing back into that pyramid pose. Straightening that left leg. Feeling that stretch behind in your hamstrings. Head melts downward towards the knee. Shoulders melt forward. Two more breaths. Let's take a nice deep breath in here. Exhale. As we float to that runner's lunge, bending that left knee. Exhale, down dog, gazing at the feet. As we walk our dog by pedaling our feet left and right, coming out the pose whenever you want. If you need to rest, may you flow into a wide-legged child's pose or puppy pose. Anybody who needs to rest, wide-legged child's pose or puppy pose. Walking our dog. Two more breaths. As we walk our feet to our hands, complete forward fold. Holding out here, and you'll still feel the stretch behind your legs and the hamstrings. Yes, it is winter time. It is cold in many places of the world. And we're just gonna use this yoga session here to just stretch and lengthen. Hanging out here in this complete forward fold, touching our hands to our ankles or the earth. Eyes are gazed down to close, allowing the body to balance and stretch. Four breaths. Two more breaths. Exhale into half forward fold, straightening that back. Gaze forward. As we yogi walk our feet apart, let's come nice and wide legged. Yogi walking those feet apart and flow back down to that wide legged complete forward fold. Wide legged straddle pose. Connecting the hands to the ankles or the hands to the earth, whatever feels best. Optioning to flow into a ragdoll by connecting your hands to your elbows if that feels good. Rocking or swaying that body from side to side. Noticing that when you rock and sway, you will feel that pull even more behind your legs and your hamstrings. Five breaths. Two more breaths. Exhaling up to a wide-legged half forward fold, straightening that back, gaze forward. And we're gonna take our Left hand, connect that left hand to that right ankle, wrapping this right hand behind our backs, how we doing to thread the needle as we gaze over that right shoulder. Feeling this wide-legged spinal twist, we are stretching and lengthening the body. This is also in inversion pose. Three more breaths. Two breaths. Exhaling back to center, half forward fold, gaze straight, backs are straight, gaze forward. Taking a nice deep breath. Exhale. As we breathe this right hand to that left ankle, wrapping this left hand around our backs, how we doing our thread the needle as we gaze over that left shoulder. Wide-legged spinal twist, opposite side. Feeling that spine lengthen. Feeling that twist, that pull behind the legs and the hamstrings. Three more breaths. Two breaths. Exhaling back to center, half forward fold. Two breaths. We're gonna hold this wide-legged stance and we're gonna slightly lift our bodies up, coming into a goddess god stance. Bending those knees, our palms are at cactus hands, and now we are working the lower parts of our bodies. Opening up those arms into the cactus hands. Feeling the back blade, the black blades squeeze towards that spinal cord as we open up that chest, coming into the cactus hands. Squeezing that back blade. Squeezing that spinal cord. Feeling that chest open. Our heart chakra is up, our chin is lifted. Taking a nice deep breath. Exhale. As we pulse our body up and down in this goddess god stance, feeling that burn. We don't have to pause, it's just an option, or we can rock and sway that body from side to side, feeling this burn. This goddess god stance is strengthening the lower parts of our bodies. It's also a stance that I would put a mom in pregnancy, because it helps strengthen the pelvic floor, it helps strengthen the legs. But a pregnant mom will only be in this pose for like three breaths. That's it. Two more breaths for us. As we find our pause, exhale, wide-legged, forward fold. This is a counter stretch. Connecting the hands to the ankles, head melts downward towards the earth. Wide-legged, forward fold. This is a counter stretch. Noticing how this relaxes and soothes the body. Holding on here for a couple more breaths. Exhaling back up to that goddess god stance, building strength in the lower parts of the body. Chin is up, heart chakra is lifted. Four breaths. Two breaths. Holding this bonus, two more breaths. Exhale to a standing star, strengthening those legs, palms come out towards the side, heart chakra is lifted, chin is up, taking a nice deep breath, exhale, feeling nice and strong in our star, three breaths, two breaths. Exhaling back down to that goddess stance, god stance. Two breaths. Exhale back up to that standing star. Palms come together above our head in that salute. As we yogi walk our feet together in our standing salute. Interlacing our fingers with that pointer finger pointing up towards the heavens. Heart chakras lifted. Chin is up, allowing the arms to flow slightly towards the back of the room. This here is a slight back bend. squeezing those shoulders towards your spinal cord, lifting and opening up that heart chakra. Two more breaths. Exhaling back to center, palms together in our salute. As we lean our bodies towards the right, standing banana. Leaning a body towards the right, standing banana. Some people also call this standing crescent moon. Three breaths. Two breaths. Exhaling back to center. As we lean the body towards the opposite side, standing crescent moon, standing banana. Slightly gazing up at the heavens. Two more breaths. Exhaling back to center. Relaxing our palms at heart center, standing prayer. Palms come in front of the chest, relaxing those shoulders downward away from the ears. Slightly gazing the eyes downward or closing the eyes. If we are pregnant, maybe coming into a nice stance, separating those feet just a little to give you balance. Here, we are in our standing prayer, eyes are slightly gazed down or closed. If that feels good for you, using this time to thank ourselves for practicing here today. As we go inward, four breaths of silence. Two breaths. Exhale, standing chair, bending those knees, extending those arms in front of you. Chair pose. We can be in a chair pose, prayer hands, palms at heart center, or extended chair. Arms in front of you, lift it up. We are working the lower parts of our bodies. Four breaths. Two breaths. Exhale, palms heart center. Twisting that body to the right if we're able. Exhale back to center. Twisting the body to the left. Chair pose twist, opposite side. Exhaling back to center. Complete forward fold. This forward fold is a counter stretch to what we just did. Noticing how this relaxes and soothes. Gazing those eyes down, nice deep breath. Exhale, feeling that head melt downward towards the earth. Four breaths. Walking our hands forward, breathing our feet to the back, down dog, gazing at the feet. Walking our dog by pedaling our feet left and right. Finding pause, shifting that weight forward, high plank or low plank. Two more breaths. Exhaling down to an up dog. Thighs are not on the earth. Up dog. Heart chakra's lifted, chin is up. Flow into a cobra, connecting the thighs to the earth. Now we're in that cobra pose. Chin is up, heart chakra's lifted. Bending those elbows, coming into a baby cobra. Torso comes closer to the earth. Exhale, Sphinx pose, coming onto our forearms. Lifting our shoulders away from our ears and ensuring that we're not sunken. Shoulders away from the ears. Their heart chakra is lifted. That chin is up. Taking a nice, deep, intentional breath in. Exhale. Gazing the eyes downward, closing the eyes. Breathing our palms into a prayer hands. With our palms on the earth, just relaxing here, gazing the eyes down, Four breaths of silence. Two more breaths. Flow into a baby cobra. Palms are flat on the earth. Slightly lifting that torso away from the earth. Exhale up to cobra, straightening those elbows. Breathing up dog, taking those thighs off the earth. Heart chakra's lifted, chin is up. Exhale, down dog, gazing at the feet. Walking at dog, pedal on that feet left and right. Finding pause, shifting that weight forward, high plank or low plank. Two more breaths. Exhale to up dog. Chest is lifted, chin is up. Thighs are not connecting to the earth. Exhale, cobra. Thighs are connected to the earth. Chin is up, heart chakra's open. Exhale into baby cobra, bending those elbows. Blow into a sphinx pose. We are on the forearms. Taking that nice deep breath. Exhale. Slightly gazing the eyes down and just taking a moment to picture how the up dog, the cobra, baby cobra, and sphinx pose all look very similar. However, they work slightly different parts of the body and feels a little different in a body. Three more breaths. Two breaths. Flowing down to our Superman, Supergirl, breathing our palms in front of us, legs are off the earth. We are working our gluteus maximus, our back muscles, our arms, shoulder blades. Superman, Supergirl, two more breaths. Holding this pose, swimming our hands to the back, locust pose. Palms are up towards the heavens if that feels good. We are continuing to work our backs, our buttocks, hamstrings, shoulders. Two more breaths. Flowing into a half bow, connecting that right hand to that right ankle. And left hand to left ankle. We are now in that full bow. This bow pose here is a nice deep back bend. That heart chakra's lifted, chin is up. Two more breaths. Exhale, relaxing the feet. Flowing the hands forward, coming into a sleeping crocodile. Stacking those palms on top of each other. Relaxing your chin, your foreheads, or your cheeks to your hands. Allowing those shoulder blades to melt forward. Feeling a body come one with the earth. One with your yoga mat. Eyes are gazed downward or closed. Flowing into a fetal pose if you are pregnant. Using this time to go inward. Noticing how we feel right here, right now, in our present moment, simply being aware without judgment. Silent meditation, five natural breaths. Two more breaths. Slowly coming out of that sleeping alligator, coming into a Sphinx pose on our forearms, shoulders are away from our ears. This is a slight back bend. This Sphinx pose is a very easy mild back bend. Two more breaths. Coming up on our knees, buttocks is high in the air. Let's flow into a puppy pose or a child's pose. Whatever feels best for you. Child's pose, puppy pose. Using this time to self-reflect. Connecting to our environment, connecting to ourselves. Five more breaths of silence. Breathing our palms together above our head, coming into a prayer hands, child's pose or puppy pose. Taking a nice, deep, intentional breath in. Exhale through the mouth. As our shoulders, our heart chakra connects to the earth. Eyes are gazed downward or closed. As we use this time to thank ourselves for allowing ourselves to practice self-care and teaching training here today. The light in me sees, appreciates, and respects the light in you all. Namaste.